In this sports Photoshop tutorial, we will learn this professional looking social media graphic that can be used for any sports team. First, in order to create our canvas, go up to File, New, and we will want to copy these exact settings. This will ensure the highest quality of design when we export to Instagram or whatever social media we're using this tutorial for. When you first create a canvas, your background layer will have a lock on it. Simply click the lock and you're ready to create. Now click on the rectangle tool and drag it across your entire canvas. If you click the fill button, it will open up this dialog box. And then if you hit the color wheel, you can select whatever color you want. For the purpose of this design, we're going to go with white for our background layer. Let's right click on our rectangle and then go up to convert to a smart object. This will allow us to go up to filter and then camera raw filter. And then we can make this adjustment. If you go into the effects tab, we want to add a little bit of grain to the background so it's not just a solid white color. All right, our next step is to create these background rectangles. This can be done by hitting the rectangle tool again and then clicking and dragging and making a smaller rectangle. Remember, if you hit the fill button at the top of your screen, you can change the color to whatever you want. All you have to do is hit the color wheel and then select your color. For this design, I'm going to pick the color of my first team. A trick that a lot of people don't know is that if you import your team's logo, you can now click your rectangle layer, hit fill, and when you select the color wheel, you can hover over your team's logo and then click to select that exact color off your team's logo. Now click your rectangle in the canvas and hit one of these squares along the outside, and this will allow you to right click and select skew. Now click the middle square and move it to the right. Insert your first player image. Make sure this image is above your rectangle layer, so our layers should look exactly the same. Right click on your player image layer and go up to create clipping mask. This will put your first player image inside the smaller rectangle. If you zoom in on your rectangle, you can see there is a black outline around your shape. For our design, we want that gone. This can be done by selecting your rectangle and going up to stroke. If you hit this box with the red arrow through it, you can now see your outline is gone. Now you'll want to do the exact same steps, but put in a different player's image. Once you have two rectangles with the player's faces on them, we're ready for the next step. Now you can select your player image and go up to filter and go into camera raw filter. Once we're in camera raw filter, we can increase the texture to 100. Let's make our way to the curves tab. You can see the adjustments that I make. They're gonna differ based on your player image, but the concept of highlights being raised, lights being increased, and darks being dropped, as well as shadows being increased, will all be the same. And the last thing that we'll do inside a camera raw filter is increase our sharpening. You can see the importance of this step in the before, and here's the after. And obviously we will do the same steps in camera raw filter for our other player image. Now we're going to create a new adjustment layer and then select gradient map. Click on the gradient map and then click on the color that is on the left side of the screen. We're going to change the color to whatever color the rectangle behind it was. For me, that rectangle was blue. And then on the right side, we want to change that color to white. Create another color swatch by clicking right below the gradient. And we're going to change that color to that same blue that's on the far left side. So now you should have something that looks like this. Again, every effect we do for one player, we do for the other. So we're going to want to do the same gradient map effect, but in red. This is the most important part of the graphic. We're going to insert these rectangles and we're going to change the color to dark gray. Following the same steps that we learned earlier, click on your rectangle, then click on one of the white squares, right click, and then skew your rectangle. Once we have our shape created, right click or control click on the rectangle layer and then find duplicate layer. Press the move tool, click on one of the white squares, and now you can move the rectangle wherever you think looks best. We're going to do the same process two more times, and we're going to make these squares a little bit bigger. For the colors of the squares, we're going to make them the same color as the player square above them. So, for example, we're going to use the red off the Avalanche logo, and then the blue off of the Lightning logo. All right, now that we got our squares created, it's time to put in some text. Hit the text button on the toolbar on the left-hand side, and then click anywhere in your canvas. Now you can type in whatever your team's name is. So for me, it's Colorado. Now after we resize our text, we want to change the font to disclaimer. I'll leave a link in the description to the font download so that you guys can use this on your graphics. You can see that this font is a lot thinner than most of the other fonts that we've used. So you're going to have to make a couple quick adjustments to our rectangle layer. Instead of adjusting the current rectangle like you're seeing I'm trying here, I'm just going to make another one. So hit the rectangle tool and then you're going to select the outside portion of the lettering. And it's going to create a new rectangle for us. And then we can follow the same steps from before where you're going to right click or control click on the rectangle, click on one of the squares, and then you're just going to skew it to the right a little bit. And then after we've done that, we can now drag the rectangle below our text layer, and now it fits perfectly. The second font that we're going to be using is called Tungsten Narrow. So you can follow the same exact process. All you have to do is click on the text button on the left-hand side, and then insert your text. Type in whatever you want for your text to say, highlight your text, and then go up and find Tungsten Narrow. So now if you look at my rectangle for the right side of the graphic, you can see that it's too big to fit the text. A simple solution to that is to click on your rectangle layer, go up to the marquee tool, and now click and drag the area that you want to cut out. Once we have done that, now we can press the mask button and it will cut out everything but the area that you selected. Now simply press Command I with the mask selected, and now you have cut out the part of your rectangle that was too big. Now you will insert a player image where you can see the floor. This can be anything. It can be a basketball court, ice hockey rink, soccer field, as long as it includes the ground or floor. Duplicate your layer by right clicking or control clicking and finding duplicate. Bring both of these layers to the very top of your layers panel. We're going to hide this one. We won't need it till later. If you're working with Adobe Photoshop 2023, you can use some of these new tools here where you can just click and remove the background. But for my picture, it really doesn't work that well. So I'm just going to use the select subject method. Remember that within select subject, anything plus you're adding to your selection and anything minus you're going to be taking away. So for example, I don't want these blue gloves of the player in the background. So I will take the minus quick selection and I'm going to click closer to my player so that it gets rid of it. Once you have your selection, press the mask button to cut out your players. Now we're going to hide this layer that we've been working with, and now we're going to unhide the second layer. Take the pen tool and now we're going to draw a square around the feet of our players. This is going to be the platform layer. There's no real rhyme or reason to this, but I do want to make sure it is symmetrical and it does look like a square. Once I've done that, I now can press Control Click within the box. It's going to give me the option to make a selection. And once I've done that, I now can hit the mask button. And when we reveal our top layer, you now have your player standing on a platform. But we aren't quite done yet. Click the platform layer and then go into the Effects tab and find drop shadow. What I've seen a lot of designers do is make their platform bold underneath, which is fine. It's just not the effect that we're going for here. For me, I like something a little bit lighter and something that's barely noticeable. Something that looks a little bit like this. The main key for me is to keep the opacity down, so it's kind of a subtle effect. We're almost done with this design, so stick with me here. If you guys are looking for this PSD, check out my Patreon. I'll leave a link in the description below. Every video that I do, the PSD will be on my Patreon. And I also do a graphics pack every single month where you can download effects like the squares and the patterns that I'm putting in the background of this video. The shapes that I'm putting in are actually part of the June graphics pack, so make sure you guys go and check that out. After you've put your shapes into the background, you can put whatever logo that you want in the corners. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make another layer. I'm gonna press Shift, Option, Command, and E. And what that's gonna do is gonna create one single layer that has all the layers that I created. And now we can go up to Filter, Camera Raw Filter, and then we can make a couple adjustments. The three things that you're gonna do inside Camera Raw Filter are add texture, clarity, and then once you go to Vignette, you're gonna add just a little bit. And what that does is it darkens the outside of your graphic, and then it centers in on the middle of the graphic. This is the before and here's the after. You can see the difference. And here's our final result.